Click subscribe for update video every day.
You, when you see an aluminum laptop case, you probably think quality, without realizing it. It's a cultural shorthand at this point, one Toshiba is trying to take advantage of with the Satellite Radius 12. You, this 2-in-1 looks great in photos, and the components are impressive. It's powered by a 6th generation Intel Core i5 processor, 8GB of memory and a 256GB solid-state drive. The 1080p display ISNT exactly cutting edge. But as you'll soon see, there's more to quality than resolution. But this Toshiba faces an uphill battle. The 2-in-1 market is crowded, and as of late has seen the introduction of strong picks like the Microsoft Surface Pro 4 and Dell XPS 12. On paper, the Radius, which has a simple 360-degree hinge, DOESNT standout. Is Toshiba hiding its trump card? Or is this another ho-hum convertible? The Toshiba Satellite Radius 12 is a visually attractive device. It's thin when closed, with brushed aluminum on both the top and the bottom. Inside the unit, a single piece of glass covers the entire display and bezel surrounding it. The backlit keyboard is inset with a few unique curves, and other than a few unnecessary stickers, it presents a clean look. It is clearly designed to appear robust. If only it felt that way. Take the aluminum, for example. Though it looks good, it's not in the same league as a MacBook's metal unibody. Look closely at the photos and you'll see the whole thing is built on a plastic frame, with a thin layer of metal covering all surfaces but the sides. Flex can often be felt, and while it likely does not reflect a functional concern, it's certainly ISNT reassuring. This flimsiness extends to the hinge, which can seem downright slippery. Opening the screen causes a noticeable amount of wobble that remains even after letting go. Most laptops do this at least a little, but the Toshiba Satellite Radius 12's movement feels exaggerated for a device at this price point. Flip that hinge all the way around and you'll be forgiven for feeling like the tablet mode is an afterthought. As with other wraparound hinges, the keyboard and touchpad are on the back of the device when flipped, automatically disabled. That's a bit annoying. Worse, the screen DOESNT sit flat against the laptop body, meaning there's a gap at the top of the screen. There's no question. Single quote.